It must be nice having the good Slayer transformation, where instead of it constantly killing you, it just gives you, like, ridiculously high health regen. I want that one.
One last time. No more hiding for either of us.
Oh my good god. Alright. Pull back. Trying to remember how we did this last time. I pulled back. And I think we did the Slayer transform. So we can afford a Slayer transform in this fight, apparently. Baylor. Except we already lost minutes. God almighty, this is so frustrating.
So we are to battle one last time.
Yeah, I remembered the end of this game being pretty frustrating, but like this is some next level bullshit right here. I do know in this, like, we have to take down to the Gobrazu first. There where, like, all of the damage comes from. Immediately kills Viconia. Love it. Alright, where is he? Yeah, this fight's pretty bad. Is he right here? No. There he is. Alright. No, we need to pull back. And we need to turn Chunk back human before the transform kills him. We can't, like, last time I gated in that Baylor to fight him, we're not gonna be able to do that this time. It's like, we just have to, like, sit back here and essentially wait. Standard tactic that. Because, like, there's nothing we can do. He's invisible. We can't pierce it because reasons. Taking some cold damage, though. I'm liking to see that. Where's my wizard eye? Ah, it's gone. Damn. For all I know, he's not even over there anymore. I assume he's not, because he's not taking any damage. Hiding over here. No, it's just a high-level fight in D&D where they buff enemy casters to the gills.
What?
You need my skills, I see.
And like, he's got stone skin on right now, so we're not gonna be able to do a whole hell of a lot and try breaching some of this stuff. I'd say I could try, Zan, are you actually gonna cast your spell there, buddy? I'd say I could try, like, holding off on using the Slayer buff, but... Oh, he's got improved spell mantle and spell turning. Chain contingency, improved mantle, spell turning, mislead. Alright, and he just mazed Chunk. And of course, now we can't target him. We can, like, every so often you see, like, his image flicker in and the cursor changes to a sword, but then it just disappears again for some reason. He's level 30. Yeah, I knew he was high level, but I mean, like, hey, we're level 15, okay. Chunk's level 12 and 14. We get to this, totally a fair fight. Reasonably designed encounter. I should have tried to hit him with a power word silence. Don't stand in now. It wouldn't be as annoying if the invisibility from his thing wasn't like, I feel like it's bugged. Because true seeing should be making him visible. But it's like, it does and then he just goes invisible again. Like, I don't know what that is. Aside from feeling bugged as hell. Chaos doing work. And like everything is invisible. I'm just gonna reload. Yeah, no fucking kidding. Like we can take invisibility purge. Proven invisibility shadow door. I mean we'll try invisibility purge. I do wanna keep Zone of Sweet Air. Silence 15 foot radius is just asking for trouble, I think. Yeah. Alright. Yes. At least we have infinite nappies.
Don't yell. I can hear you just fine.
True sight. And protection from evil. I want to get the invisibility going. I'm gonna hit Chunk and Minsk, I think, with improved invisibility. The important DPS. Okay. Do your righteous might. Do your haste. What is your will? Quick save. Alright, let's see how this works.
So we are to battle one last time.
I grow tired of your
and Slayer.
Speak. Give me a task.
Okay, and as for protocol, I have to pass out healing potions because I just keep forgetting.
Swords!
Right, what I'm just gonna have Minsk. Everybody gets the drink.
Guides my hand.
And I'm gonna try and keep Chunk in the Slayer mode for just a minute here. Okay, so he's porting, I think. Yes, where are you going? Down here? Okay, get down here.
You know this.
Invisibility purge.
Not right.
God, that cast time is painful. Just invisibility purged. Look at that, still fucking invisible. You love to see it. Can't target him.
Give me a task.
Jacques, I shall follow your strength.
Like, this feels so bugged. So fucking bugged. Oh, fuck off. We're in the middle of a boss fight. And, like, you can see, because, like, every so often everybody attacks him because I have the AI on, but because of his, like, weird flickery AI shit going on, like, with his invisibility, it's just not doing anything. And he, of course, can just stand there and throw whatever magic he wants at us. Am I needed? Like, yeah, what is this? What am I supposed to do here against the caster who's got, like, crazy health regen, infinite spells, and, like, mega invisibility? Yeah. Destiny awaits. Oh, hey, he's visible now that, like, the majority of my party is incapable of doing anything. Woo. What the fuck was... What the hell was that? I mean, whatever it was, it didn't actually hurt him at all, but... Huh. Oh, and he's invisible again, because of course he is. I mean, like, nothing I can do here. Boss is, like, fucking invisible. Can't de-invisible the boss. Summon Monster 8 or 9, that's a cute joke. I don't even think anybody in my party can cast level 8 spells, let alone me having summon monster. Alright, so he's visible now at least. I mean, that's something.
Armor, jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be a
cheat back, yeah, the temptation is strong.
Why?
Genie dead. But guys! Ah!
Yes.
Okay, Chunk's got the haste. Let's... Ah! Bring people back with mints. That's actually a good idea. Although, I mean, yeah, Zan, I guess, would be helpful. Minsk even can activate it. Of course, we're gonna have to gear him up and stuff. I'm gonna check something. I'm gonna see if this invisibility is working as intended or not. And if this is not working as intended, I'm gonna throw a shit fit. Currently contains a bug that makes enemies disappear on loading. Well, that's fun, but not what I'm looking for. Baldur's Gate 2, final fight bug? Let's see. Thing crashes. Thing that there's a lockup. Oh! So you get him to near death, which we did, and no matter how long you attack him, he doesn't die. Because... oh, this is an old bug. Never mind, this is from 10 years ago. So this is probably... probably the bad... the original release. I just want to know if this is, like, worked up. Final bug, invisibility. Bet the bug was not fixed, maybe. I don't know. The only bugs that I was seeing was like,
come on, let's kill something now.
Hang ups and stuff, keeping the fight from progressing and stuff. Let me flip through scrolls one more time. Like, I just, like, it, that feels bugged, just how that is working. It just does not feel right. Load a file. Throw the BS in the fire. No, I want to kill him. Master and companions are immune. Like, and the other thing is that, you know, I'm a spellcaster heavy party, and everything in this fight is resistant to magic, so my casters can't do anything. Which, I mean, well, no, our party isn't that heavy caster-wise. We've got decent melees, but I don't know, it's just really, really fucking painful. Go jelly. The jelly may be a solution. We can try the jelly. I don't think it's gonna work, but we can try the jelly. What is your game? If this works, you're getting a medal, you little...
So we are to back.
Oh, yeah. Oh no, I do have to say though that immunity to plus one weapons is really doing a lot for us. Yeah, no, Jelly didn't do nothing, sadly. Here. I'm gonna reload. I just do not know.
I can hear you just fine.
How can I help?
Jelly beats beholder. It's like rock, paper, scissors, but jellies. So I could, all right. I can get 5 improved invisibilities. I'm gonna get 5 improved invisibilities. I'm going to invisible everybody except for Viconia, because she doesn't deserve it. Okay. Of course, knowing this, all of these things have improved, like, true seeing anyways. It's like true seeing, but better. No matter what, they just see you. And we're fighting fucking John Cena over here. Not level 30 myself. No fucking kidding! Holy shit.
So we are to battle one last.
True seeing, but it actually works. There you go. I like that. Okay, Slayer, and then Hulk out, Minsk. You just look busy, buddy. Oh, I'll wait. These things just do not miss. It is absurd. What is this, bitch? Fucking Glabrazu, leave fucking Jan alone, you son of a bitch! Gnome Bro did nothing wrong! God. Oh, no. There's Pappy Fuck Bucket. Everybody out. Nope. 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 Not dealing with you right now, buddy. Do that. Alright. See, like, this wouldn't be bad if I could save right now. Like, okay, we got through the first phase, but the game's like, nah, bro. You gotta do this. It's like the ending of fucking Kingmaker, where, like, we're just gonna throw this, like, fucking nasty boss fight at you, and you have to do the whole thing in one go. If you insist. And it's just like, ugh, kill me.
Whatever.
Alright, now where's,
Guides my hand.
Alright, do we have protection from evil? Did I remember to cast that? I think I did.
Sharpened and
yes, okay. Victory. All right, we got protection from evil. You know, so now we start gating things in to blow through this shithead spell list. Like, taking some damage, which makes me want to stick my nose down here and see what's going on. Oh, it's attacking the illusion, that's why. Okay. Just like fucking wailed the thing, man. I wish my spells were as effective as his are. Holy shit. Have another one, friend. I know that all of our, like, our invisibility and stuff has fallen off. Oh, there's Death Fog. I'm glad that that Pit Fiend soaked that Death Fog and not me. Because that is a nasty, nasty spell. No, didn't mean to cast that shit. Okay, he's visible for the moment, but I'm not going down there. He's gonna be immune to spells. Remove magic. Where's Xan? Where's that warding whip spell at? That seemed to tentatively do something last time. Of course he's immune to everything. Oh, now he's invisible again, so we're just gonna fuck off elsewhere. You can sit down there and be an ang- oh shit. Like, this is... like... yeah. Like, okay, so is he out of spells then? He's just gonna follow us around. Now it's all down to the pathfinding being a dumpster fire. I was gonna say, yeah, he's gonna start killing people. As Chunk gets stuck on him. God almighty. And like, we literally can't do anything in this game right now. This is the game. Run in circles. Okay, no. Baldur's Gate to EE cheats. I want to at least like see if there's something to dispel this. Because like, this is like, we are just having our time wasted. And I am not okay with that. That is where I draw the line. Okay, oh, we have to... I think we might have to edit an INI file for this. Otherwise, it's not going to let us do anything, is it? Control space? Yeah, it's not going to let us cheat unless I exit out and have to do this again. Yeah, like, this is ridiculous. Like, let's run around in a circle for 20 minutes while all of our buffs wear off and he can just, like, has carte blanche to beat the shit out of us. Like, that's fun. I don't know what I want to do. He's gonna have immunity to, like, all of our spells, I think. And, like, his regeneration is... just so absurd, I don't think we're gonna be able to put him down. Alright, I heard this weapon is useless. Which one? Plus two? Probably the plus two if I had to guess? I'm gonna actually swap Chunk over to just fighting with this plus four short sword. Lilar Core is plus three, I think. Should be good. Yeah. And this is plus three as well. Yes, okay. Plus three should hopefully be enough. He wants to beat on Minsk. I am okay with that. Less okay now. Hot Slayer on Slayer action. Like, it's just no. Like, what the fuck? It's just asinine. Absolutely asinine. Alright, so we have to quit. What do I have to do to enable cheat codes? It's like, I'm okay with a challenging boss fight. Lord knows I'm okay with a challenging boss fight, but this is just not right. Alright, we need to find Baldur's Gate 2.ini.
This must be what using your brain actually feels like.
Well, there's a Lua file. They change it from an INI. No, maybe. Program options. Okay. What do we need? Debug mode. Hopefully this doesn't break anything. And hopefully it's the exact same debug mode. Alright, I'll see if this works. Or if it crashes, everything in the world burns.
You really need to clean me. I like to shine.
There we go. Okay. Alright. Okay. So what can we do here? Display traps, item codes, adds. Wait, we can like summon monsters. Oh, that's cool. God bow, explore, give gold, give XP. Oh, that's nifty. You can just kind of go wherever you want. I don't really want that. I would just like, heal character. Kills creature the mouse is on. Doing this on bosses is not recommended. God damn it. 18 across the board. Remove characters from party. I mean, alright. Where is it? I just saw kill things. Control Y. So.
You really.
Alright, yeah. It works. Nifty. Like 10 levels? Nah. I'm gonna just kill the ads. Like, I wanna just do the fight against him and see if we can actually get through this. I'm just tired of having to micromanage through these four ads every time. Seems like his death sequence is sometimes bugged. Reloading is recommended. Yeah, that was what I saw as well, was that, like, he wouldn't actually enter the phase where you're actually able to kill him, essentially. Okay, so just like, Alright. But I mean, like, he still just immediately misleads and is gonna just sit there and start, like, throwing death magic. So, like... What do we do? What can we do? Wait, Jan just shot him. How?
A standard tactic that.
Speak it will be done. Give me bearing now.
How can I help?
Yeah, imagine like getting to the end of this fight and then he just bugs out. Spell ineffective because he cheeseballs himself into having immunity to everything. Hey, he's visible. I guess that counts for something.
What if you insist?
This isn't boring. I'll give it that.
Cannot equip weapons while shape changed, but I can certainly unequip weapons. All right. Near death. Oh. I'm not playing with any mods, though. Well, now we got Xan, I guess, but... No, I think... Of course, I kill the ads, and then the first time we do the fight, we survive and kick his ass. Like, fucking hell.
I'm going to have to leave. I cannot tolerate this.
When the priestesses told me that your body was showing signs of life once again.
Apparently, Nalia's fucking off. Good riddance. We resurrected you who we could, but it seemed nothing would draw your spirit back. We were about to give up when you began to stir this morning. I didn't even have to cheat on him. I just killed the ads. Like, that was literally it. Kill the ads, dispel the shit out of him. God almighty. Couple days, no more. However you managed to find your way back, it is good that you have done so. Despite your reputation, you've done a great service for the elves of Sold the Nessalar, and to lose you to death after all that has occurred would be a terrible thing. I have planned a small ceremony to reward you for your actions and to show our gratitude, despite what your motives may have been. You should rest now and regain your strength. I will send a priestess to awaken you when it is time.
Those of you who have survived the return of the exile to Sol de Nessalar know me, your queen. But only some of you know the hero beside me, who was most instrumental in saving our city and the Tree of Life. Many dark deeds have been associated with your name elsewhere. But here today,
what?
We offer sincere thanks to you for the great service which you have performed.
Dark deeds? Chunk has never done a dark deed in his life.
...were not performed alone. Sol de Nessalar also extends its gratitude to those who have traveled with you and fought by your side to help save our city. There is little that would make a suitable reward for such deeds. We offer to you the thanks of our people, as well as gold and the Amulet of the Seldarine, to remind others what you have done for us.
How people are getting past that fight without cheating? Yeah, I was gonna say, yes, they probably played more of the game, because, like, relatively speaking, this party is actually fairly low level. Like, we're about 15. You can, by the time you get here, you can be, like, 18, 19. And just having, by way of having, like, 9th level spells and stuff, you would be able to do more in that fight. Like, for example, that Scroll of Kelvin's Warding Whip. If I could cast that regularly, I would have been able to spam that, and that would peel, like, a lot of his magical protections off and let us beat the shit out of him early. But that would require us to be able to target him, and with his weird invisibility thing being bugged or whatever... Like, I don't think it would have helped, but, yeah. I don't know, I think the big reason that was so hard was because of whatever was going on with that mislead spell, that, like, our true seeing couldn't see through it. Like, that's why that was so much bullshit. Because if I could just see him and target him, I would have just had my melees do what they just did to him, and it would have been okay, but, yeah. Because, I mean, like Sol says, you know, dispel and implode in him in seconds. I mean, look at how that fight was there. The invisibility wore off of him, and then my melees just took him apart. So...
As for the man whom we once knew as Jon Aleth, I can only say that he died long ago. He lives in my memory still. To the man he became, the exile, Irenicus. He who performed atrocities on you, the tree, and his former people, to him I can only send my prayer that he finds the peace in death he never found in life. I feel I must apologize on his behalf for what he put you and your friends through. For his madness, we stripped Jon Aleth of his elven immortality and exiled him, only to create Irenicus instead. I cannot help but feel we are partly responsible. It is something I shall have to ponder on. As for you, I am sure you will be leaving soon. As a wanderer, I imagine you are eager to resume your travels. Go with the best wishes of Sol de Nessalar.
And thusly, we were booted out of town.
Rain from the sky! to end like this. Orion's ward has become too powerful. We should have acted long before now.
There is no reason to be concerned. The fate of this fool has been sealed.
But can we be so sure?
This spawn of Baal is doomed. There is no escape.
There is no peace for a child of Baal. You've learned this lesson time and again, as all who are close to you suffer because of your tainted blood. When Jon Irenicus fell, you had hoped for some sort of respite. But peril follows you like pestilence. The time of the prophecy has come. Five powerful Baal spawn have arisen, leading their armies across the Sword Coast, slaughtering their weaker siblings and innocents alike in a wave of massive destruction. Like wildfire, panic spreads before the armies of the Five, and those suspected of being children of Baal are cast out and revived. Even in Sulden Essalar, unease grows into fear at your presence. Queen Elysium urges you to visit a sacred grove where the ancients might shed light on your fate. You wonder what part you will play in the dreaded prophecy, and how long before its culmination devours your soul. Only one thing seems certain. So long as Baal's throne of blood stands empty, chaos shall reign.
Chapter 8, this is the beginning of Throne of Baal. Well, this is, I think, an introduction into the Throne of Baal, if I recall correctly. Look at that XP gain. 2.5 million experience points. And a random potion of antidote laying on the ground. Neat! Well, let's get our leveling done here. We are not going to be playing Throne of Baal, by the way. Hide in shadows. Alright. And I'm actually going to give Minsk, where is it? I want to give him proficiency with long swords. Considering they're everywhere. They didn't gank my gear, not yet. Alright, she leveled at least twice. Bunch of extra spells. Hey, what about you? 6th, 7th, 8th level spells, nice. Then... first, second, third. I think he gained two levels, one of which is a thief level. Here you can have some open lock too. All right. grab spells real quick. Look at all these first level spells. Totally necessary. All those cure light wounds that I don't... I would cast more spells if I had more hotkeys to hotkey them through. It's just fucking cumbersome scrolling through shit to find all of them. Let's see. That's invisibility purge. I'll keep a couple invisibility purges. Zone of Sweet Air is a game changer. Dispel magic. Serious wounds. I'm gonna keep her with Righteous Might, I think. Another heal. And nothing at 7. Yeah, no kidding. Feel like wounds for days. Chain lightning. Delay blast fireball. And she actually has no 8th level spells. What is, no, don't remove it. Pierce magic, oh, that's the magic resistance I always forget. Death spell, creatures with more than 8 die are immune, alright, so. Zan, I gotta get Zan better 6 level spells. I suppose I'm worrying about things that don't really matter because this is kind of the end and I'm just doing this so that I have it for when I create the save. And then people can begin with the, when are you going to play Throne of Ball? And I'm just going to be ignoring it for months and months. It would be great. Another Agonizer Scorcher. Minsk, you get any extra spells? You did. I have a Bark Skin, and I just really like the idea of Minsk killing things with bees. It's funny to me.
Give me a task.
First Daggerfall. Oh yes, absolutely. That is absolutely what we're playing next. And you can all thank Celt for it. Yeah, so we don't even have saves here. Yeah, autosave Throne of Ball. 01. All right. Well.